I no longer considered my body as something disgusting and ill. Far from it. I began to look at myself, to caress myself, and smell my own skin. I began to explore and experiment, finding physical pleasure. My ideas were not very clear, and I never spoke to anyone about these things. Bruna, however, spoke about them. She boasted about her love stories and her young men. To my eyes, she was very lucky, always being wooed. By marvelous, generous, and kind boys. Thus, I fantasized about her adventures, pretending that I was the main protagonist. But how could I ever be like her? Occasionally, I recall that she had black and blue marks on her body, but I was so naive that I did not understand. I did not put two and two together. It was Don Gino who explained things to me a few years later. He told me about Bruna's father and brother. I was already very ill. The light had returned, and that thing made me suffer even more. It was my world, and it was crumbling. When I spoke to Bruna about it, she turned her head away and was silent for a long time. Prince Charming doesn't exist, Renee. At least not for us. I was 14 years old. I didn't think it was possible for a boy to look at me and desire me. When he asked me if I wanted to go for a walk, I didn't say anything. I didn't even have the courage to look at him. Things improved for a number of years, then suddenly, everything came crashing down. One evening, I came home drunk, and the following morning, a terrible crisis overcame me, all of a sudden. What had I done? I was terrified. I thought I lost my sight. The light burned my eyes from inside. The memories of the previous day emerged in bursts, images, flashes, which unleashed something monstrous inside me. Repetition of words was no longer sufficient. Now there was a voice in my head which repeated them louder than I did, and they were words of accusation and blame. So I covered my ears and shouted and hit my head against the wall and threw up. I remember the doctor, the wall filthy with blood and vomit. My mother wasn't looking at me. Bruna was crying but trying to hide it. Charlotte was beside me. I never told anyone what had happened. He came to visit me, but I refused to see him. I became agitated. I think he liked me, even though things turned out badly. In that period, I began to suffer from memory loss. The few things I learned didn't please me at all. He told me that I was looking for him. It was all my fault. Bruna told me that sometimes I got drunk. People in the village gossiped about me. Sometimes I was covered in black and blue marks. I didn't realize what was happening to me, what I was doing. I was no longer in control of my life, from my little corner. Accused, hurt. I chased him away. I insulted him. He was proud, handsome. He said things about me to other people, which he shouldn't have said. Mother caught me coming home drunk. She beat me. and sent me to speak to Don Gino every day. He came back and tried to speak to me. I think he liked me. Sometimes I sent him packing and I started shouting at him. But other times I embraced him. I held him tight and loved him. But he couldn't bind himself to me. I was 16 and ill. I had no future. I didn't get out of bed for weeks. Then I did things I was ashamed of. I slept with men. The guilt tore out my soul. And the light came back to torture me. I invented stories to justify my actions. I couldn't bear my own weight.